Imagination on fire. That's how it was for me. I always asked so many questions. I drove my parents and teachers wild. And yet, I just had to know about everything. The world was so full of wonder and glorious things. And my questions paid off, for look at all I discovered. Ah, who am I? I am Galileo Galilei, astronomer, mathematician, and adventurer extraordinaire. And now I'm a bit of a time traveler, flying here, appearing there, across time and space. And now I'm here to be your guide to the wonders of the universe, the possibilities of the future, and the lessons of the past. Now, this is quite a huge task. You might even call it cosmic. So I consulted my notebook here and discovered some stars of another sort. They're the dancers of the New Hampshire Dance Institute. With music and dance, they'll guide us all on a journey to worlds both strange and familiar. The first stop on our journey grants us a look at the nighttime sky. Jupiter is visible tonight, and the SWAT team is ready to take flight. Things that inspire me as much as looking up into a starry sky at night. Here's your chance to make a wish with these dancers from the Cutler School. days, moonlit nights. Looking up and seeing our fellow travelers in space reminds me of my connection with the universe. The dancers of the Westmoreland School have a wonderful way of expressing this connection.
Got no diamonds, got no pearls, still I think I'm a lucky girl. I got the sun in the morning and the moon at night.
Got no mansion, got no yacht, still I'm happy with what I got. I got the sun in the morning and the moon at night.
Thank you.
maybe even a close encounter of an unexpected kind? Just ask these dancers from the Monadnock Regional School.
He's on down the road.
The distances we travel make for very long journeys. Light years, even. Well, that's no trouble for these dancers from the Great Brook School. They've got a time machine.
Human
It's good to come back home and appreciate the joy and beauty of good old Earth. It's a rich and wonderful world, filled with plants and animals of every description. Here are some very lively Earthlings, high-leaping creatures from the Well School.
Was a bullfrog, was a good friend of mine.
Never understood a single word he said, but I helped him in bringing his wife. Yes, he did.
Began. Once again, I'm the young boy, looking up into the sky, dizzy with wonder and filled with questions. How is this amazing universe designed? And what does the future hold in store?
future. Feel the fires of the mind. A heart that's open wide allows a dream to grow. It's the dawn, but near the end, a miracle is
tonight, because we have with us a really very wonderful person. He is someone who believes very strongly in the importance of the arts and children, and has devoted years of his life to making this possible, that children have a wonderful experience in the arts using dance. And I would like to now introduce Jacques d'Amboise.
Up here, and Peter at 250 stars on stage. I'm filled with pride and joy at the way this program has flourished in the past 10 years. Thank you all for being here.
And now we're going to begin Act Two and rejoin Galileo, and I'll turn you over to our chief astronaut, Peter Mansfield.
Most of you know me as an astronomer and inventor, but I was also a rather good musician, something I learned from my father. I never really felt a need to separate these things, music, art, astronomy. It seemed that they were all part of the same wonderful and exciting universe, part of the adventure of being alive. Oh, and I wondered about everything, all the time, asking question after question, and it seemed that every answer simply led me on to the next question.
Expand and the wonder simply grow.
That thought they had it all figured out. Remember the dinosaurs? They thought they had it made, and we know what happened to them.
Yeah, love came by the one. ask so many questions is decidedly bizarre. All we have to learn was settled many years ago. Why does the sun go around the earth? We already know.
Investigating now would really rock the boat.
For we agree with everything that Aristotle wrote.
Galileo, Galileo, you're too curious by far. Spending all your evening staring at a single star. Thinking for yourself can be a lord and a wise. For learning here and everywhere are
ignoritious lies.
Thank you.
attention to the heavens. And not only did I trace its fiery path across the sky, but I also found myself drawn to the billions and billions of other lights up there. As I gazed at them, it was as if they were speaking, sending me brilliant, flickering signals. Began to soar. I saw more possibilities for the future that seemed endless. I saw flying ships, men walking on moons, and perhaps even on other planets. Words and pictures would be sent through the air. Sometimes these new wonders were beautiful and exciting, and sometimes they were, well, interesting.
Television.
Oh, Mr. General Public, do you realize that we've got a generation here of staring eyes? The children never bother getting homework done. They just sit around looking at television.
Billy's never running, playing out the door. On top of that, they're never reading books no more. You ask them who the father of the country man, they say either Walt Disney or David Letterman. Oh, television, television, I'm a sick from looking on television.
I got the weak in the arms,
weak in the head like lies, from sitting and looking on television. Television, television,
I'm sick of it.
Television, television, the children of the country eat their dinners, you bet. Eating from the TV, TV set, they
with bad commercials on the lawyers you see. If you do the thing through with an accident, they'll get your money.
Or learn a Jedi way.
share my discoveries with the people of my time, and not just the scholars and other astronomers, but the real, everyday people. So I wrote a book about my belief that the universe was far more vast and wonderful than anyone had supposed, that there are scientific realities which can be tested through experiment, that the universe is organized with a wonderful geometry of which we are a small, but nevertheless amazing part. I also explained that in our solar system, the Earth and the other planets revolve around the sun and not the other way around. To be certain that lots of people would read this exciting news, I wrote my book not in Latin, the language of scholars, but in the language of my people, everyday Italian. It was a sensation. The word traveled like wildfire. I called my book The Starry Messenger.
Look, observe, inspect, behold, message from afar. Watch and learn, the truth is told, blazing from a star.
Galileo will learn to hold his tongue. skull. Perilous fool, tampering with the accepted rule. But now we're here, it's payback time. Galileo will answer for his crime.
No, 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 there's nothing new in the heavens. It's all words we already knew. We don't want new ideas coming at us out of the blue.
Perhaps a dungeon, murky and cold.
Let him away till he's tired and old.
A little fire, the easy way.
We will spend the break and all of the day. No, 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 there's nothing new in the heavens. We all have, we already knew. No starry-eyed astronomers creating the hum of a moon.
Whoever would have thought that ideas and questions could be considered such a threat to people who had so much power? What did they have to fear from an honest search for the truth? Whatever their fears, they had me arrested and put on trial for heresy, a crime for which some scholars have even been burned at the stake. In this dark hour, I was only saved from the deepest despair by a strange and wonderful sense of the future, which I suddenly felt all around me.
Heretic, deceiver, these are the words that my enemies cry. Blind to the beauty and truth in the sky, those who condemn me have more to fear than I. Renegade, ungodly, I feel the curses cut deep to the bone. Yet still I can dream of wonders unfold. But why must I die in a dungeon alone?
Thank you.
guide us, visionary spirit.